Hello there. My name is Hotazo, aka Blueysha. I'll explain that one day. And welcome to my first ever video on my channel.
I'm a horse. Time for me. Hey.
So the main reason why I decided to even do this is because I spend so much time in solitude. I live alone in a one bedroom apartment, which I will show you around as time goes on. My backdrop is my kitchen. As with each video that I make, I will be sharing my apartment with you and just my style.
I'll start right over here. This is my kitchen bench where I have my breakfast or lunches it's a big center place, I guess, for me to sit. So if I have friends over, I usually serve lunches and stuff on it. It's quite small, but I usually don't have big crowds of people around, so it works. Love this. Britain, some flowers, can never go around with some flowers. Microwave, my cookbook, something I'm really, really big on. Jars with rice and cereal. And all that good stuff. Kitchen sink, boards. A girl can never have too many damn boards. Okay. Sugar basins, coffee, and tea. My cup tree, love this. Specifically because I've got these metal steel type mugs, which are very nostalgic for me. I remember growing up at my grand's house and she'd make us tea in these, but obviously these are a little modernized. And then with these copper ones, I spray painted them, so they were also silver, and I spray painted them copper to fit in with the overall theme of the apartment. I love very, so the feel of this is very rustic and very homey. So you'll see there's a lot of copper that comes in, a lot of browns, hints of whites and off-whites here and there, but yeah, it's just supposed to feel very homey more than anything else. Stovetop, knives, paper towel, and yeah, I think that is it. Oh yes, and little centerpiece. I'm thinking I'm gonna need to change this though and get one of those boards, the ones that I could write on with chalk, or maybe I'll DIY something like that. And yeah, I will show you the rest of the apartment as time goes on, but for now the focus is the kitchen.
I'm gonna go ahead and get started. I'm gonna start by oiling my pan. I'm gonna be greasing my pan, girl. I'm gonna use some butter, jigger's brick, and I just grabbed a little piece of the paper from it, and I'm literally just gonna go inside and just spread all around, just greasing the entirety of it. I hope I'm showing you what I'm actually doing here. So I'm going to start with my dry ingredients. I'm going to go ahead and sift in my flour. Ooh, girl, should be a little more careful. Here we go, sifting in the flour. So this is my baking powder teaspoon. This is your teaspoon of baking soda. Yep, all of in there. Cup of sugar, like just over half. And snap, I forgot a teaspoon of salt. Cool, so not a full teaspoon, just like a quarter type situation. Like that much. And that's gonna go in there. And then I'm gonna mix all of this up. Show you. So that's what that looks like. And I'm just gonna mix all of that up. So I'm gonna use this bowl. This is actually my my stand mixer bowl, but like I don't know why I don't have bowls. I'm so disappointing. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and put in my wet ingredients. Two room temperature eggs. I stress room temperature eggs. Because yeah, no, these eggs will show you, they'll show you some things if they're not room temperature. I don't know how many cakes I've had flop because the eggs were too cold or the butter was too cold. And yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and put in my oil. I'll show you what's happening on the inside after I've put everything in here. And my cup of Inkomazi. That goes in there. And vanilla essence. So I'm just gonna put one on the lid, and I think that should be sufficient. So with a fork, I'm actually just gonna go ahead and mix all of that. You just want it to combine. Then to my dry, I'm just gonna create a little well here in the middle, and I'm gonna go ahead and add the wet ingredients, and then I'm just gonna fold it in. So here is the wet, and I'll actually show you. And as mentioned, I'm just gonna go ahead and just give this a bit of a mix. So you definitely don't want to over mix this. You just want everything just well combined. So yeah, this is what the consistency looks like once everything is incorporated. Sheesh, I forgot to add something. I forgot to add the lemon juice and the lemon zest. I'm gonna add half of the juice here, but I'm also gonna add the lemon zest that I get from here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and squeeze in the lemon into the batter. Go ahead and peel in some lemon zest into the batter. Don't know why I forgot this. In my head, I'm already planning how I'm gonna add the blueberries, but baby girl hasn't even, you know, considered the lemons. And I did say I'm making a lemon and blueberry cake. Side note, the girl is turning 30. Well, the girl is 30. And I've never actually left the country. So sad. But yeah, that's something I definitely really wanted to do this year. However, it's also pretty late now to plan something for December. So we just decided to do something local for now. And then I think around April, May-ish, we will do Mozambique. So this is me mixing. And then later on in in the year, we will go ahead and do something a little more out of Africa. Here are my blueberries. I'm just gonna take a handful of them, maybe two handfuls, because we want the cake to be as berry full as possible. I think that should be sufficient. And we're just gonna add these to the cake. This is spatula right now. I don't know how effective this is going to be, but I just want them to coat the flower so that the berry, well, be coated by a little flower at least, so that the berries don't sink to the bottom of a batter. Yeah, I think it's doing the job, That's one of that. I am gonna go ahead and add the berries to my batter. And I'm just gonna mix the berries into it a little, just enough for them to incorporate. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add my batter to my tin. That is what she looks like, and I'm gonna go ahead and put this in the oven at 180 for around 30 to 35 minutes. So I went ahead and took the liberty of setting up my stand mixer off camera. So yeah, so you wouldn't just chow into time just watching me set up this stand. And for my icing, I'm gonna use cream, regular whipping cream, Pick and Pay brand. And I'm just gonna go ahead and plunk all of this in there. To this, I'm also gonna add icing that I had made last week, cream cheese icing. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that. But first, I just want this to firm up a little when I incorporate all of that. And to that, I will add lemon juice and a little vanilla essence. And let's go. Here we are. So that looks like that. And I'm just going to fold it in there. I am gonna go ahead and pop that back in the mixer for like 10 seconds, being very careful because I really don't want it to curd, and low speed for 10 seconds. I believe it is time to check up on this cake. I think it should be done. She looks brown. Let's take her out. Ooh, it smells so good. I'm gonna go ahead and place this on my wooden board. And I'm just gonna go ahead and put a toothpick in there, and it is clean. Ooh, that is hot still. But I'm gonna go ahead and release it from the pan so this can pop cool on all the sides as well. And boom, she's looking pretty. So while I sit around and wait for this sponge to cool, I decided that I'm gonna go ahead and make a quick berry coulis. So I've got some strawberries in here, some blueberries, got quite a bit actually, and some raspberries, if I remember where I put those. I think it's behind some raspberries and some strawberries. I'm gonna get load shedding in a bit, so this is gonna be the quickest
hoodie you've ever made to that. I'm gonna add some sugar, just a handful of that, and some lemon juice. Already smells amazing. Just mix that around. It's coming along real, real nice. Smells amazing. Strawberries are also slowly just melting, and we just want a very cooked soft type of consistency because we want this to be liquidy. The raspberries and the blueberries have already really cooled down. I just think the strawberries need to follow suit, and yeah, so this is going to be part of the decorating, but also just a layer in the middle of the cake, just to add that extra berryness to the lemon and blueberry cake. I know this is the cake is lemon and blueberry, but I do think that a good coulis is just berries upon berries.
So as this cooks, well, as it sits, sorry, it will thicken. So this is what it looks like, and I'm just gonna go ahead and pour this in there. The sponge has cooled. It's been about an hour and a half, and I'm just gonna go ahead and cut this in half. So I just went and finished off frosting the cake. This is a very semi-naked type of style cake where the cake isn't entirely covered and parts of it are exposed.
We have officially come to the end of the video. Thank you so much for spending your time with me and getting to know me. Yeah, I'll see you in the next one.